think I can get them here. Oh, sure. All right. Now, I've got some announcements for you.
First off is that I'm excited that y'all came to see our stars for the Christmas pageant of 1996. And a lot of hard work, a lot of preparation has gone into it. So I'm going to give you some announcements, and then we're going to take up the offering, and then we're going to let it get underway. Okay? Now, the children have all been talked to and told to sit quiet so we can hear. And I know they're going to cooperate, and they're going to set a good example for all of us, aren't they? That's right. So the announcements, I want to tell you, first off, I want to say thank you very much to everybody who's volunteered in any way. Remember a long time ago we folded letters in the gym, stuffed in letters, the envelopes in the gym? And then we started with the Christmas kettles. We had volunteers in taking Christmas hamper applications. Then we still had volunteers on the Christmas kettles. And then we had people come in and put all the hampers together. And we gave a lot of them away. There's still a few that are straggling in. But we want to thank all of you because we couldn't have done it without the help of so many. So now, I want to tell you that Monday and Tuesday, Julie still needs some help for the Christmas kettles. There's a sign-up sheet out there. I promised her, I'd mentioned the Christmas kettles this morning, just say it's the last 2 days, folks. We get the Christmas kettles through, and it'll be terrific. Julie also probably would like some help sorting food coming the next couple of days. So I promised her I'd mention these things and just let you know to respond and just to help us out where you can, when you can, and how you can over the next couple of days. Tuesday night, ladies home league.
No.
At home. Home league's at home with your family. You heard those chorus and those. That's right. It's time to be home. Next home league will be on the 7th of January. Want to remind you all, Wednesday, December 25th at 11 a.m. is the Christmas Day service. And December 31st, New Year's Eve, we're going to gather for some games, some fun. And 11 o'clock will be the watch night service. This morning is the Christmas pageant. And tonight is candlelight service. Candlelight and carols at the celebration night. The topic for the message tonight is 3 things God wants you to have on your Christmas list. 3 things God wants you to have on your Christmas list. Well, we've got some wonderful children who are going to take up the offering today. And they're going to come up now. They're going to stand in front here. Then we'll pray. We'll take the offering. And I'll get out of the way and let the real stars come out and shine. Heavenly Father, I thank you for your love. I thank you for the freedom for us to gather. And Lord, I pray that you'll bless our concert, Lord, our time together. And Lord, I just pray to help everybody remember the words and for things to go well. Lord, as we give to you of what you give us, Lord, I pray you'll bless the offerings and tithes and help us build your kingdom. Thank you, Father, for all the moms and dads, aunts and uncles, Lord, and friends who have come today. Lord, I pray you help us all to have a good time to celebrate the birth of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
lunch afterward, and we would be delighted if all of you stay.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. remember Marley.
Oh, that was so many years ago. Ah, humbug.
I see a change in presentation by the meddlers.
Thank you.
close my eyes to enjoy it better.
The next number will keep you awake. It's the juniors and the teens.
Have one question to give you to keep on your mind. I just
just have to say is, what do you think of Christmas? My name is Stan Levee from SATV Channel 6 News. I wish you a very, very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, and may God bless you all.
Might as well sing to pass some of the time away.
Thank you.
You must be the visitor of Christmas future.
Hush, Scrooge.
But this is the past. There must be some mistake. Where is the future?
No mistake, Scrooge. Without Christmas past, Christmas in the future holds no meaning.
Lead on.
And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for him in the inn.
They not make room. It's a sin. Do something, Marley.
You do something, Scrooge. Go on.
And there were shepherds living out in the field nearby, keeping watch over their flock at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news and great joy that will be for all people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men, on whom his favor rests." When the angel had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to them, "This is what Bethlehem and Jesus sang in the passage which we heard in the Holy Ghost." So they hurried up and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger.
I remember a song from when I was a child. Let's sing it.
Jews, we saw his star in the east and have came to Bethlehem.
He sent him to Bethlehem and go out of the search for the child. Child, as soon as you find him, of course we say, that I may go and watch you. After they had made the king, they went on their way. And the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them.
Oh, Marley, I've been so wrong. Is there any hope?
I see rejoicing in heaven, Scrooge, but you're not there. I see you in chains.
Marley, it can't happen. Make it different. Surely this job can change me. I want to be changed. Take me to worship the child, Marley. Take me.
Come, Scrooge. All can come.
Where am I? What am I doing here? It's Christmas morning. Thank you, visitors. Thank you. I'm free. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. It's Christmas. Thank you. Thank you.
Not just embrace the Christ child that we all so warmly welcome at Christmas time, but also to embrace in our hearts and our lives the risen Christ of Resurrection Day. The choice has to be made in our hearts, and that choice can only be made by each one of us. And it's up to you. It's up to you. Let's pray together. Father, running through my mind just now are the lines of the song, where meek souls will receive him still, the dear Christ enters in. And Father, as hearts are quieted before you just now, Lord, I pray for hearts that are open just to say yes to you. Hearts that are open to respond, to invite you in, to become a part of their life. And Father, for that heart this morning that has just opened up and just to receive you, just to say, yes, come on in, Lord. I pray, Father, that especially you'll come in and bless us Christmas season. Father, help each one of us, all of us, Lord, to walk in harmony with you. Help us to keep you in our hearts. Help us, Lord, to walk in your ways. Father, I thank you for the children. Lord, for what they learned in Sunday school. And Lord, for their talents and abilities they use today. Father, I thank you for the teachers. And Lord, for what they give to the children as they learn about Jesus. Father, I thank you for each one who took a part this morning. Just pray, Lord, you'll bless them as they minister. Thank you, Father, for time we've shared together this day. For this morning. In Jesus' name. Amen.
I want to thank you all for coming again. I hope you enjoyed it. What do you think? Did they do a good job?
They did a terrific job. What a reminder that the soup and sandwich lunch, if people were bringing sandwiches in, they got a pot of soup. It was so big. We want you all to stay and to join us. And I'd like us to stand and just maybe bring our time to close together by wishing, by singing, we wish you a Merry Christmas. I don't know if you got the music or the baker. Thank you.
aren't you? Oh my. Side thing here in the yard.
That's an improvement.